Hi, today we are going to look at the second stage of the Treasure Blitz event. If you have seen my video on the gathering, just want to show that I in the end ranked 18th in stage one. I was quite happy with that, didn't expect that when I was making the video. I was starting quite late, but with my third March slot and the gathering boost that I used, I think especially those two helped me still get quite far. So not a huge amount of rewards, but for example the 16 hours of speed ups that I get, I can definitely use again today. I'm again a bit late starting with the event, the stage. Today's stage is the upgrade, building upgrade stage, I should say. In quite some similar games that I've played, building and research were combined into one stage, but here it is, are two separate stages. Today we have building, or exactly, actually today and tomorrow we have building, and after that comes the research stage. So we actually have quite some time to do the buildings. What was quite surprising compared to gathering, actually, if we look at the points, I have done one, or now, by now two building upgrades, but when I did only one building upgrade, which was my academy to level 13, I think, I already got all the rewards, but still at that time I ranked outside of the top 1000, and now because I haven't done that much after, I'm even ranking in the 3000. So yesterday, if you would complete, if you would get all the rewards, you probably had a place, a position into the top 100 ranked. But this this time it's a totally different balance between the individual points and the necessity to rank. So yeah, this means that already more than 3,000 players for sure have reached all the point rewards. Okay, how do you get points? For every 1 point increase in power from upgrades, you will get 5 points. You can see how many points you can get from the more info you can see for each level. And I think you should look at the power difference. So going from 13 to 14, that is a little bit less than 200,000. So that's already giving you times 5, so 1 million points, if I understand things correctly. What are the preparations for this stage? Well, it's very important that you, or very important, it's important to have a high construction speed up boost. Normally time is going to be a major factor. There are not that many ways to increase that in any significant manner, but if you look at the research, in the development tree, we have a couple of construction projects. You start out with one, and later on you have another one, and that's it, I think. Yeah, those two is it. But it would be, yeah, it's nice if one, the ones you can reach, to already max them to the extent that you can. That's yeah, it's always nice to get a little bit extra construction speed boost to go for your time as far times faster. If you look at the talent trees, in the economy tree you have also I think three construction projects, so you start out with one as well, and here we have another one, and then further down the tree is a third one. They all don't give a lot. It's 1% per level. I think the last one might have 10 levels. Let's look at it. Also only 5 levels. What you also have, and what gives quite a significant boost, it's not really construction speed, but it deducts 20% from your timer for any timer you start within a period of 30 minutes after activating this talent. So this is a talent. So that is that is going to be quite quite nice and quite helpful if you can reach that point. I'm still a bit away from that, but this stage, the Lord level upgrades still go quite fast, so I hope to reach that soon, but I'm not going to do that during this event, unfortunately. But this is quite an important one that you should definitely use when you do big things like a stronghold upgrade. What more construction speed? The VIP level also gives you a small construction speed boost, or small construction speed boost starting for VIP 4, it is 10%. I think it goes a bit up later, but that is definitely a nice extra to have. So yeah, there are other benefits as well. I'm not there yet. Started a bit slow with focusing on VIP, but definitely next time this event comes along, I should be there. I should have that unlocked, and that nice 10% extra is definitely going to help. So what other things do you need to do for preparation besides getting these boosts up? That is collecting a lot of resources. Well, partly you can do that by doing a lot of gathering in the day before, because the day before this was a gathering stage. And in general, I would say save up your resources for this stage of the event and for the research stage next. There you might need a lot of resources. There are different ways besides gathering and having open resources, which is nice, but there are also other ways. I still have unclaimed main quest, and if you claim these, you also get some resources and they will be helpful during the event. Not claiming them, I don't claim them, because when you claim them and you have a lot open, besides that the food gets eaten if you have many troops, but also you can get attacked by other players and you can lose all your resources. So better keep them unclaimed so that they are safe, so that you don't make yourself a target in case somebody scouts you, and then just use them in the moment you actually need them. Same for a lot of items in the inventory for resources. I don't have that many, but still quite some, and they are going to be helpful and safe as long as they stay here like this in your inventory, and you open them the moment you actually need them. So that is also a good point of preparation. Besides that, of course, stocking up on your construction speed ups and general speed ups is going to help you as well. If you want to do well in the ranking, you probably need to use quite some speed ups. So that is also something to focus on. And something else that I actually haven't focused on is to get your embassy up, but I plan to still do that. But getting that up to a max level with each level of the inventory, each level of the embassy, you get more timer help duration, so more seconds deducted for each help that you get, and you get one timer help extra. Sorry, if you are in a large active alliance, being at level 8 or at level 13 or 14 can make quite some difference. If you do a lot of small buildings, it can really help quite a bit. I mean, for one large building like a stronghold upgrade, not going to be a huge difference, but I have so many buildings still at a relatively small level. It is definitely going to help me if I can upgrade this. So that is something I plan to do. I plan to focus on first next. Okay, for the rest, I think this is it for the preparation. As I mentioned, looking at the power increase that can help you determine on which buildings to focus. I actually have the feeling that maybe it is not that different. In some other games, you should really do the stronghold upgrades, but here, okay, the stronghold upgrade is 200,000, and here I only get like 40,000 points, but maybe the timer is, if I go from 13 to 14, that is the comparison I make, but maybe the timer difference is also going to be huge, and the resource requirement difference is going to be huge. Maybe that is also a factor of 5. So from that point of view, I'm not yet sure. Maybe it is just as beneficial to do many small ones than focusing on the stronghold upgrades. Since I'm quite far behind with my building upgrades, I plan to focus on them anyway, focusing on the small ones. And you can also look ahead a bit what you actually want to do, what you need for later in the event. For example, now part of it I'm focusing on upgrading my troop training buildings, getting them from level 10. These two are still level 10 to level 13. This is already 13. This is about to go to 13. I do that because I want to, when the troop training stage comes along, I want to be able to train higher level troops, which is going to give me more points, especially if I already start with a large batch of those. And I'm also maybe today, maybe during the research stage, but also plan to max out all my military tents, because they also have a benefit for the troop training stage later. The military tents increase the training capacity and the training speed as well. So those are things to focus on. What you should definitely do as well, just now getting some general tips, what you should definitely do as well, have the extra builder active, actually by spending the money to unlock it permanently, or spending the gold to unlock it for a certain number of days. That is definitely going to be very useful for this event, because it means you can do two buildings at the same time. So basically, yeah, or you have a lot of benefits. If you look at a 48-hour event stage, which this is, that just means that it saves you 48 hours of speed-ups by having this second queue. So that's definitely going to be useful. Actually more, because you get the helps for this as well. If you look at the preparation for the event, it's good to start with two building upgrades that finish shortly after the stage starts, so that you already start out with quite some points without having to spend speed ups on that. I was a bit late with my construction, so that when a stronghold upgrade, so that one is still running, but I did do it with the academy upgrade, so that worked out better. One other tip, the Seamaster statue, I could have gone here from somewhere else as well, actually, but it has I went to the trident, but I wanted to go to the crown, has a harvest talent that you can use, which cuts off some time depending on the level, so I still have it at quite low level. I can actually, but I've already used it today, but I can use it tomorrow again. Anyway, I will do that later. This is a bit boring to do during the video, but I can increase it to another level and then it goes up a bit more. So that's definitely a nice one to focus on. For the rest, the production I'm not too crazy about, so I'm not sure whether this is really a very useful one to focus on, but early on this talent is quite nice. For the rest, yeah, I still have to make a video on the Seamaster statue, but I have a bit of feeling that better to focus on the combat parts to upgrade those. You can activate it from this ability menu, so I already activated it actually. Okay, anything else? I think this was it. I hope these tips help you do well during this event. I'm going to try to see if I can rank with the top 100 again, but that I have currently no idea. I haven't even checked how far away I am from the top 100. And of course, after 2 days, we also don't know how that is going to play out. I'm just going to do my best. I want to do a lot of building upgrades anyway, and we'll see how far I get. Maybe I make a video from this stage of the event again tomorrow, if I have something more to show. We'll see about that. If you have any comments or any questions, that is always much appreciated. And thanks for watching this video.